It's always been about me, myself, and I. Before relationships were nothing but a waste of time.
It's just not
I never wanted to be it. Anybody's other half. I was happy saying I knew love it wouldn't last. That was the only way I knew till I met you. You make me wanna say I do, yeah, I do, I do, 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 do. Yeah, I do, I do, I do, 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 do. Make me wanna say I do, I do.
Did you know
what I do? I do, I do, I do, I do. Tell me, is it only me? Do you feel the same? You know me well enough to know that I'm not playing games. I promise I won't turn around and I won't let you down. You can trust I've never felt it like I feel it now. Baby, there's nothing we can't get through. Say I do, I do, I do, 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 do. Oh baby, I do, I do, I do, 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 do. Cause every time before it's been like maybe yes and maybe no. I won't live without it, I won't let it go. What more can I get myself into? You make me wanna say meet my family.
Coming at you, she's coming for you.
She's smiling?
Yeah.
As long as she's not running away.
You know what? Because. John, come here, come here. Yes, good. Yeah. You wanna go get her?
That we dreamed of once in a lullaby. Oh, somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly. And the dreams that we dreamed of, dreams really do. Come to
welcome on behalf of Mark and May to their special day. Would you please gather in close? I know they really want you to hear every word and be right close to them as they exchange their wedding vows today. I know they deeply appreciate your presence with them. Would you join me in a word of prayer, please, as we begin this ceremony and hold hands? Lord Jesus, it's good to be here this afternoon. We can hear the sound of the waves. Their thundering noise reminds us of your power, God, and your love for us as well. The warm sun and the cool breeze reminds us of your comfort and your love. And we pray now that you would be in this place, that this would become a holy place, more than just a beach, but it would become your sanctuary, where Mark and May can say their words of promise to each other and remember them all the days of their lives. So we ask that you would do the work that no man can do, and that is to transform this man into a husband, this woman into a wife, and that you would make that equation of 1 + 1 = 1. And we ask it in your name, Jesus. Amen. Mark and May, I want you to know that it's my honor to help you with your wedding vows. I found in you two people that have considered deeply what you're entering into. You have a love for each other that is worthy of the wedding vows that you're about to take. Weddings are one of my most favorite things to do as a minister, and I think it's because I like getting dressed up and looking good with everybody else. But seriously, I do enjoy helping couples take their first steps into married life as well. My wife and I have, over the last 38 years, dedicated ourselves to married couples, to helping them in every way that we can. The kind of love that you two have for each other is described in a passage in the Bible, 1 Corinthians 13, a familiar passage. It reads like this: love is patient and love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast. It is not proud, it is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. And now these three remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. An impossible definition to live up to. But Jesus Christ fulfilled all those promises, all those words, when he gave his own sacrifice of love on the cross for each and every one of us. And Jesus said, "Greater love has no man than that he lay down his life for a friend." There's a beauty in that paradox of giving yourself away, of laying your life down. And you two have already begun to do that for each other. Mark, May says that you make her feel secure at home. She can be herself when she's around you. That her heart leaps when you're around. That you're everything that she's ever needed in life. Nothing else satisfies like you. And May, Mark says that you are beautiful inside and out. That he can fully trust you because you are guileless. What you see is what you get when you get May. Mostly, though, it is your kindness that impresses him. You two, the secret of married life is that, just what we read and heard about, it is giving yourselves away day after day after day. When you think you have nothing left to give, you keep on giving and dig deeper. There's an infinite source within you by God's Spirit and his power to love each other. Never quit, never give up. Love never fails. In just the next few moments, you're going to say words of promise to each other. It'll really be the rest of your lives that you fulfill these words. So I'm going to ask you to turn and face each other and hold hands. I'm going to start by asking you a question, Mark. Mark, will you take May to be your lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, in sickness and health, for richer or poor, for better or worse, forsaking all others as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Good. And May, will you take Mark to be your lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, in sickness and health, for richer or poor, for better or worse, forsaking all others as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Good. Mark and May have written their personal vows to each other, so I'm going to ask them to exchange those now. And Mark, I'm going to ask you to begin.
Put me on the spot, you know?
Yeah. Let's see what you got.
5 pages.
From the moment we met, I knew I was in big trouble.
As we sat on the park bench by the church house, I felt myself like a schoolboy, stumbling to make conversations, awestruck by your stunning beauty. I was captivated by your beautiful smile, your alluring eyes, and your bright and happy face. At first, I became aware of the obvious. You were simply gorgeous, clearly one of God's most beautiful creations. I loved your hair. I loved the way you walked. I loved your contagious smile. I loved the way you held my hand and always welcomed and needed my touch. I loved your hugs and your endless supply of kisses. As time proceeded forward, I learned you were more than just a pretty face and that you were very different from all the rest. I learned that you were the kindest, most giving person I had ever met. I learned that you lit up the room every time you walked through the door. I learned that you were kind of hyper and never slowed down. I learned that we had lots of fun together and that we had much in common and enjoyed almost everything together. I learned that your picture was next to the word crazy happy in the dictionary. And finally, I learned that on a scale of 1 to 10, you were an 11. But then I learned more about you, that most of your life you had placed others' needs before yours. I learned that you had sacrificed your happiness, needs, and wants so that others could survive. I learned that you delayed your dreams and gratification so that others could be safe. But most of all, I was amazed that such a tiny body like yours could be the wellspring of endless supply of love and happiness and kindness. I learned that you would undoubtedly place my life in front of yours without hesitation. I learned that I wanted to be more like you in many ways. And finally, I began to learn that I wanted to spend the rest of my life with you. And so it is little wonder that our love began to grow and grow and grow. And so this day I choose you, and I pledge my love to you and none other. I vow to be the man you deserve, realizing that I'm not quite there yet. I will love you and cherish you all of my days. I will treat you with kindness and respect and love you all the days of my life, and will honor my marriage covenant to be faithful and true. I give to you my heart, mind, and body, my ears to hear your voice and listen to your dreams, my back so that you can jump on it if you ever need a pickup. I give you my shoulders to rest on and to dry a tearful eye. I give you my chest to lay down a weary head. And I give to you my hands and arms to hold you and carry you and comfort you. All that I have within me I give to you. May, I love you. I love you. I love you. With all my heart, let's grow old together.
Mark, I've always believed in fate and destiny, but I also believe that ultimately it is the choices you make in this world that lead you to the people who can change your whole life. Only in my dreams did I think it was possible to be this in love with another person. Honestly, I'm amazed that I'm about to say I do to my best friend, surrounded by the people we love most in the world. You gave me the love that I never thought I would find, and for that I am forever grateful. You have a way of making me feel special in a way that no one ever has before. You never fail to make me feel like I have priority in your life, no matter what commitments you're juggling, and you make me feel special, beautiful, and worth something. The amount of effort and compassion that you put in this relationship amazes me till today, and I've come to learn that for a guy so big and strong, you have the most gentle and nurturing heart. There are countless of indications that I have truly found my soulmate, from the large grand gestures that fill my heart with joy to your subtle way of my baby. Reminds me of how much I am loved and how much I love you back. I will never take for granted everything you've done for me, and I wake up every day with a thank you on my mouth. I'm thankful for this life we are able to build together, and I'm thankful for our loved ones who support and care for us so much. Lastly, I know I've found my soulmate because nothing I do in my life is complete until I'm able to share it with you. Love you.
Love you,
babe. Continue holding hands.
It's beautiful, babe. It's beautiful.
Well, I think we should get those rings, please. Uh-oh. The tradition of exchanging a wedding band is a long one. It actually does come from the Bible. In the Bible, when two people would make a promise with each other, they would often exchange a symbol of that promise making. In the Bible, that was to take a shoe from your foot and give it to the other person. I'm not sure what that really signifies, except maybe now you could step on my toes since I made these promises. But we've upgraded that tradition of exchanging that symbol to the wedding bands. Mark and May, as you place these wedding bands on each other's finger, they're to be a token or a symbol of the gift of your heart to each other. I've been wearing this wedding band for 38 years on my finger. It's the gift of my heart, or my wife's heart, to me. Wherever I go, it reminds me she's trusting me with her heart. And likewise, the ring she wears is me trusting her with my heart. So, would you please take her wedding band and place it on her ring finger?
Right now?
Yes. Hold it there. And repeat after me, Mark. May I give you this ring.
May I give you this ring.
As a sign of my devotion and love.
As a sign of my devotion and love.
And with all of my heart.
And with all of my heart.
I promise to you
all that I am. All that I am.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I marry you.
I marry you.
Join my life to yours.
And join my life to yours.
Thank you. And would you place that on Mark's ring finger? And repeat after me.
Mark, I give you this ring.
Mark, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my devotion and love.
As a sign of my devotion and love. And with all my heart,
I promise to you
all that I am. All that I am.
With this ring,
I marry you.
And
join my life to yours.
At this time, Mark and May are going to participate in a sand ceremony. And I think it's a beautiful image of two lives coming together as one. As the Bible declares that there is a oneness that occurs between a husband and wife. And so I'll let that imagery speak for itself as they step forward to the sand ceremony.
Oh. clouds won't hide the sun. Blue skies of Hawaii smiles on this our wedding day.
I didn't know you guys were artists, too. All right, at this time, I want to ask the children of Mark and May to come forward with their spouses, and we're going to pray just a blessing over them, over Mark and May and their family, their newfound blended family. Bring the little ones, too.
Grandkids can come.
Oh, yeah. Just come right on up. Yeah, you want to have parents?
Just kids.
We can have the moms too.
Moms?
Yeah, go ahead.
Moms too.
Where's mom? Where's Mark's mom? Mark's mom? Okay, why don't we all hold hands? The family members? Everybody connected? So, Father in heaven, we ask now that the windows of heaven would be opened up, that you would pour out a blessing on Mark and May, their children, this extended family and blended family. Father, give them everything necessary for the journey ahead, patience, perseverance, hope, faith, that you'd give them forgiveness and sacrifice, that all that come into Mark and May's home would sense the love that you have poured out in their hearts. So do that work, God, in their lives through the coming days of just uniting this family and bringing them closer to you and to each other. And it's with a lot of anticipation of celebration this evening that we ask these things in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. All right. Okay, you can go back, family.
Go back.
And now, by the authority committed unto me as a member of the Gospel of Jesus Christ, I declare that Mark and May are now husband and wife according to the ordinance of God and the law of the state, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Whom therefore God has joined together, let no man put asunder. You may kiss your bride. No, yeah, this is a guarantee. You can take your flowers.
Is he going to kiss the best man now?
And turn and face your guests. It gives me great pleasure to introduce to you now Mr. and Mrs. Mark Cowdell. And then we can give them a great big group hug at the end of that aisle.
Almost more than I can take. Baby, when you touch me, I can feel how much you love me, and it just blows me away. I've never been this close to anyone or anything. I can hear thoughts, see your dreams. I don't know how you do what you do. I'm so in love with you. It just keeps getting dark. Your hair all around me, baby, you surround me. You touch every place in my heart. Oh, it feels like the first time, every time.
Brand new couple, Mr. and Mrs. Caldell. How about you guys put your hands together?
Sometimes I cry, but I'm
follow Torrance here. Are you guys ready?
Yeah. So my name is John Heyman. I've known Mark probably sometimes since June of 1976, and every day from that day to this day has been a dreadful one for me. No. So it's a precious thing to say that you've had a friend for over 40 years. Maybe we all can't say that, but I can say that about Mark. He's been like another brother to me, and that's a very special relationship. And I'm just happy to be here with him and his new lovely bride, May, who is obviously legally blind. But, and deaf and dumb, too. She's Helen Keller. No. To celebrate this beautiful day of unity and happiness and love, and it's a pleasure and honor to be here. And so I just wish you the best, and I love you both.
Mark, no, oh yeah. Cheers.
Right there. All right, Carl, I'm thinking for toast
number two. FYI, I'm really bad at public speaking, so just bear with me on this speech. It's pretty short. So I wanted to talk about family or love. And so I settled on a combination of both. First and foremost, I want to say my mom is someone who I've always looked up to my whole life. Despite any struggles we've been through together, she's always taught me to look at the light at the end of the tunnel. This has never been more true than with the idea of love. She taught me to always keep my heart open, and that when a door closes, God will always leave a window open, or at least cracked. So. Something. She taught me that love arrives when it's supposed to and then leaves when it must. That sometimes love is not what you expect, but exactly what you need. That love may be a bit older now, not too old, but it's definitely just as beautiful. I know when Mark first came into my mom's life, my first thought was if they were good together. I realized when she came home with a smile before that I've never quite seen on her face that he was someone who made her so incredibly happy in a way that no one has before. And for that, Mark, I'll always be grateful. When you guys are together, you guys act very corny, googly-eyed teenagers, and it's ridiculous, and I think you know that I roll my eyes 90% of the time. But I think it's one of the most genuine love that I've ever seen before. And I'm so happy that you guys found each other. So I want to end this little speech with a quote from my favorite poet, that said, once you find love, it's like discovering the ocean after years of jumping in the puddles. So here's a toast to my mom and Mark for finally discovering the ocean. So cheers. I love you guys.
Thank you.
1, 2, 3.
I'm scared of you. I'm gonna make it.